All too often, a spindle is replaced without getting to the root cause of the problem, which leads to another failure down the road. So before you go through the trouble of replacing your spindle, let's stop and do some troubleshooting to rule out any other issues. Here we have a spindle that seized and quit running. But what caused it to seize? Most often, the root cause is lubrication, as in the spindle is not getting enough oil. Pay particular attention if your machine has a Bezier pump. As they age, these pumps can sometimes work intermittently, so even a successful lube test is no guarantee that the pump is good. These pumps should always be rebuilt when a spindle problem is suspected. And if the pump is over 5 years old, a rebuild is necessary anyway. Check out HaasParts.com for the rebuild kit that includes the gear motor, and don't skip this step. And if you've got one of these older pumps that's using either Vactra 2 or DT25 oils, switch those out for our current spec oils, either mobile SHC625 or a high-quality synthetic 5W20 automotive type oil. Both of these are direct replacements. If your machine has a Haas metering valve style pump, check for air leaks and bubbles inside the tank at the bottom of the valve body and in the tube that carries oil into the sight glass. If you can see air bubbles, the pump isn't properly lubricating the spindle. Also be sure and check for oil leaks at the sight glass. If oil is leaking here, the spindle is not being properly lubricated. Remember, if any of these problems are not corrected, your new spindle will seize just like the old one. Now let's talk about a spindle that is running hot. The most common reason for this is too much oil reaching the spindle. Check your lubrication system and make sure that the proper amount of oil is being delivered. The procedure for this varies depending on machine model and pump type. Refer to the documentation for your pump that's available at diy.haascnc.com and follow the proper procedure. Fixing this will most likely correct the problem and will save you from replacing the spindle. Next, let's consider a spindle with a noise or vibration problem. Before replacing the spindle, always check to make sure that your tooling isn't the problem and that the spindle is balanced properly. We have a video that covers that procedure. On an inline spindle, make sure that the spindle and motor are properly aligned. This is also covered in our spindle balancing video. If your spindle is belt driven, make sure that the belt tension is correct and that the belts and sprockets are clean and in good condition. Last, let's talk about a spindle where the tool is sticking. When dealing with a stuck tool, the spindle is rarely the problem. It's much more likely that it has to do with the tools being used and the application. Really long or heavy tools can lead to the tool fretting in the taper. You should take a careful look at any applications using these types of tools to ensure they aren't contributing to the problem. Also, go back and take another look at the spindle temperature. Tools are more likely to stick in a hot spindle. Deal with the lubrication problem we talked about earlier, and you will probably solve your tool sticking problem as well. One last note. If the drive dogs or spindle taper has been damaged by an orientation problem, this must be corrected before you replace the spindle. Bottom line, spindle trouble is often the result of a host of external issues. With just a little troubleshooting, there's a good chance you can solve the problem and be back up and running in no time. Thanks for watching.